Ever since the advent of the recent COVID scare, the idea of a new normal has been hypnotically broadcast by the mainstream media. The cult of normality has never been more visible or more dangerous than it is now. By selling this idea of a new normal, mainstream culture has itself become a dehumanizing religion, a dangerous cult, out of control. The new normal demands total surveillance and a radical suppression of individual freedom. Without vigilance, we could witness the creation of a global totalitarian state. So how do you know if a cult is dangerous? We see enforced isolation, excessive controls on behavior, controls on types of clothing, restrictions of leisure time, hypocrisy, controls on when, how, and with whom members associate, induction of dependency and obedience, refusal to consider alternative sources of information, activities of others reported to authorities, dissent is discouraged, questioning authority is not allowed, individualism is discouraged, groupthink promoted, systematic lying, individual behaviour is monitored, distraction to prevent independent thought, doubts and questions prohibited, polarised black and white thinking, us versus them mentality, obligation to perform absurd rituals, permission required for personal activities, reduced access to wider news sources, use of loaded language, reduction of complexities into buzzwords, hypnotic techniques used to undermine conscious thought, shame and guilt are prevalent, rejection of rational analysis, ties cut with friends and family, practice of financial exploitation and dependence, rigid rules and regulations, withholding and distorting information, extensive use of propaganda, suppression of critical thinking, infantilization of members, cultivation of fear and dread, individualism is deemed selfish, induction of social guilt. If you agree that our society is exhibiting traits of the cult of normality, remember that it can be difficult to rescue people from a cult. Concerned friends and family are usually recommended to follow these guidelines. Number 1. Inform yourself. Find out as much as you can about what's going on. It's difficult to convince anyone without solid evidence which makes them question their beliefs. Number 2. Stay connected. It's very difficult to build bridges with someone who thinks they're being attacked. Expect accusations and avoid violent reactions. Keep in touch and remember that compassion will be the most effective means of helping. Number 3. Build trust. Maintain connection and be consistent. Moments will arise when you can share more directly. Number 4. Exploit opportunities. At some point, the victim will have to realize that things are not as they believed. Patiently wait for those moments and be ready to connect during those times of doubt. Don't forget, there's no bigger cult than the cult of normality.